Think that you're a businessman. As a businessman, you will need certain factors of production like land, labor, capital, and materials to produce any commodity. Hence, you will have to incur some cost to produce any output. However, once your output is ready, you will sell it to people outside and earn revenue out of it. This makes studying cost and revenue extremely important for any business. Welcome to the Sagar Rao channel, friends. Let's study cost curves and revenue curves. We first start by understanding costs. Let's look at total cost. Imagine that as a businessman, you plan to open a clothing store. In the beginning, you will incur certain cost on things like buying place to open the store, hanger to showcase your clothes, buying lights to beautify your store, etc. Notice that in the short run, these costs will be one-time cost, something that you don't have to incur again and again. Hence, these costs are called as fixed cost. However, after you have started your business, you might incur costs on advertising, purchasing new clothes to sell, paying electricity bills, etc. These costs are not just recurring, but also something that keeps on changing. Hence, such costs are called as variable costs. And fixed cost and variable costs together combined give us total cost. We saw earlier that fixed cost is fixed in nature. This means no matter how much the amount of output I produced, my cost will remain the same. Hence, my fixed cost curve is a straight line. On the other hand, variable cost is changing in nature. Hence, the curve will be an upward sloping curve which showcases change in cost. Notice that to increase output, we need to increase our cost as well. As we know, the total cost is total fixed cost plus total variable cost. Hence, we need to start our total cost curve from the place our fixed cost started. Now, let us look at what is meant by marginal cost. Marginal cost is the cost incurred by the firm for producing an additional unit of output. Say, as a firm, you have produced 10 ice creams. The cost that you incur on producing the 11th ice cream is called as the marginal cost. If you have produced 11 ice creams, then the cost of producing an additional unit, that is the 12th ice cream, is the marginal cost. I hope that made sense. Now, every firm at its initial level of business enjoys certain benefits that leads to a decrease in cost in the beginning. These benefits are referred to as increasing returns to scale. After a certain point, producing extra makes the firm incur higher costs. These are decreasing returns to scale. As the cost in the beginning decreases, the cost curve comes down. As later it increases, it tends to go up, making marginal cost a U-shaped curve. Like total cost, average cost is also divided into two parts, the average fixed cost and the average variable cost. How do you average anything? You just sum all the elements and divide it by the number of elements. Well, that is what you do over here. You take total fixed cost and divide it by the output that you have produced, thus giving you the average fixed cost. You can notice an interesting thing over here. The total fixed cost doesn't change, cause it's fixed. Hence, as the output increases, the average fixed cost will keep on falling. And if you draw this on the graph, you get a downward sloping average fixed cost curve. Notice that as output is increasing, the average fixed cost is falling. Now, let us see different revenue curves. There are three types of revenue curves: total revenue, average revenue, and marginal revenue. However, these curves look different in perfect competition and different in imperfect competition. You can see my previous video on monopoly versus perfect competition to understand these market structures. For now, let us see how these revenue curves will look like in perfect competition. Perfect competition is a situation where firms are selling identical products, for example, eggs. Hence, in such a market, all the firms have to charge a uniform price, otherwise they lose customers. Hence, the price of every additional egg that the firm spends will remain the same. Because of this, the marginal revenue curve in perfect competition will be a straight line showcasing constant revenue earned. On the other hand, in imperfect competition, a case such as monopoly, the marginal revenue curve will be different. In monopoly, the monopolist can only sell more quantities if he reduces price. Reduction in price means reduction in revenue from every extra unit sold. Hence, your marginal revenue curve will be a downward sloping curve here. In perfect competition, your total revenue curve will end up going up constantly. This is because you constantly keep earning revenue with every additional unit you sell. However, in imperfect competition, your total revenue will only rise till the time you are earning something from the additional unit you are selling. After you stop earning, your total revenue will start falling. Notice how total revenue starts falling exactly when the marginal revenue curve hits zero. By now, we must have understood that average revenue will be total revenue divided by output. In perfect competition, the marginal revenue is constant, say rupees 5. Hence, the total revenue will increase at a uniform rate like 5, 10, 15, 20. If you now divide total revenue by output, you will end up getting average revenue of 5. You see, you will always get average revenue equal to marginal revenue in perfect competition. This is why average revenue curve will overlap the marginal revenue curve. You can pause the video and think about this if you found it difficult to understand. In imperfect competition, the total revenue rises but at a decreasing rate. So if we do total revenue divided by output over here, we see that the average revenue keeps on falling. Hence, the average revenue curve here will be a downward sloping curve. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, then do like, comment, share and subscribe. Until then, adios. Hasta la vista.